starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
Don't know what this world's coming to. Says here they got over 50,000 men working the mines down there in the Congo. Lordy me. Why, back in the good old days out west, man would take his burrow and maybe a partner, and that'd be the whole blamed outfit. 50,000 men. All of them experts. Experts to find the gold. Experts to dig it. Experts to build a road. And experts to haul the stuff away.
What did they do before experts, Uncle Petrie?
Why, in the good old days, a man had to be an all-around expert, or he'd die out there in the wilderness.
He must have been awful smart in the good old days.
Smart, I say. Wasn't a prospector worth his salt if he couldn't sniff out a vein of gold with his nose.
Sniff it out like this?
Of course, you have to have a nose for it.
What if the gold is way down deep?
Didn't matter to a good gold sniffer. Yes, sirree, Bob. You take a man digging for gold. There he was, off by himself, with no one to do his thinking for him. Had to do everything, even his own engineering. And some of them old mines are still standing to prove it. Look what it says here. Every mine and smelter has a fully staffed hospital to tend the miners and their families. Why, what are they bragging about? In the good old days, a man took care of himself.
Didn't you have any doctors in the good old days?
Oh, sure we did. But we didn't coddle ourselves. Supposing I was out mining and my partner busted an arm. Let's see. Men were men in the good old days. You can take it from me.
Okay, we'll take it from you.
We'll take your audience, too.
Huh? Oh.
And he was going to stay up so late because it's Friday night.
Well, I'll bet him down, Ruth.
Oh, you'll have to fight me first.
I know you'd rather cook your own lunches, but this will give you more time for mining.
Thanks, Mrs. Martin. Thanks, Mom.
Now, where will you be?
In the hills at the far end of the lake.
All right. I'll be back before dark.
Okay.
So I can smell better.
Why don't you smell down low? That's where the gold is.
You try smelling down low.
Could smell gold?
That's what they did in the good old days.
Do you smell it?
I smell something.
Let me have a try.
Think it's gold?
I don't know.
If we only knew what gold smelled like.
Well, we might as well dig here.
Okay.
Oh. so suspensive.
Yeah.
Maybe we better try someplace else. What's got into her?
Maybe she smelled a gold mine. Come on.
Thanks. And more.
Want to come out now?
I'm afraid I can't.
Well, then I'll help you.
My leg's broken. Maybe my back, too. Your folks around?
No, sir. Just Boomer and I.
If you could slide that door under me. No, you couldn't pull me out.
You mean like on a sled?
Yeah. But it takes too much strength.
I could get Lassie. Uncle Peachy showed me how to hitch her up. And then she could pull. Come on, get your rope.
Thanks, fellas. You live near here?
Over by Calverton, sir.
Oh.
Gee, this is awful.
Uh-huh. You must have hit your head awful hard.
Remember when I fell on the tree? My bump was nearly as big as his.
Uh-huh. Mom put cold water on it, too.
Makes it stop hurting.
How's your back?
Well, it isn't broken, but someone will have to go for help.
I'll send Lassie.
Hadn't you better go instead?
Lassie can run faster.
Well, you can trust her, all right.
She brought us here, didn't she?
The Martins will come flying as soon as they see her.
And we'll be here to take care of you. Lassie, go get Mom and Dad. Hurry. And don't forget Uncle Petrie, too. Be careful.
Oh, I had to see if I could sit up.
Maybe your leg's okay, too.
Oh, no, it's broken, that's for sure. I'm gonna need a doctor.
If this is the good old days, you wouldn't need a doctor.
What would they do, shoot me?
Oh, no. You'd do like Uncle Petrie. You would send it yourself.
Oh, that's for the doctors.
Not in the good old days. Uncle Petrie'd know how to fix it as quick as you said Jack Robinson.
I bet you he couldn't. I bet you.
I'll bet you he could. And I'll bet you could, too.
Me?
You could try to put a splint on it.
Well, okay. But what's a splint?
Just a straight board or a piece of metal, say. About as long as my leg. Maybe you could find something in the plane. Try and find two. What happened to that dog of yours?
Lassie? She's probably at the farm already.
Did it?
I don't know.
Feel anything?
Where's Lassie? Where are your folks?
Don't worry, mister. Please.
They'll be here any minute now.
I'll go look.
See them coming?
Not yet.
They ought to be in sight by now.
Stopped. Boomer, there's something inside my plane, behind the pilot seat. A kind of pistol with a big fat barrel.
A pistol?
Yeah. And there's some other things that look like giant firecrackers.
I'll get them for you.
No sign of them yet, mister.
Maybe they weren't home.
Well, she'll find them anyway.
I found them. What you gonna shoot?
This is called a Very pistol.
What's it good for?
Well, during the war, a downed pilot was taught to use every means he could to get help. This is one of them. It's really a signal flare.
We're not allowed to light signal fires.
Yeah, the brush is awful dry.
Well, this shoots straight up, and the flare will die before it hits. I wonder what's wrong with this thing.
Lassie's on her way back. I know she is. Mr. Matthews, please. Just until I take another look.
Me. I'll be all right.
Lassie,
mind serving me, Ruth? Thumb's too all fired sore to help myself.
Oh, whatever happened to you?
Oh, you know that bent blade on the harrow?
Oh, yes, we're old pals.
Did he tell you about it?
No.
Reckon was all that talk last night about man having to be an expert at everything.
Funny, I didn't expect them back before dark.
Anyways, I decided to fix the blame thing myself. There isn't a doctor could have done a better job on that thumb.
They are inside. She wants us to go with her.
Something's happened.
Oh, don't get alarmed.
Now, they were going to the hills at the far end of the lake.
You okay, Blair?
I'm getting tired, kinda.
Me too, kinda.
I smell smoke. There must be a fire somewhere.
There it is. Hurry, Paul. I know it's Timmy.
Somebody better get here soon. Maybe you ought to run for help. Maybe you ought to.
Okay, we'll fight her together.
You can thank Lassie for saving your life.
I'll talk to you later.
Get that big one, Paul.
Timmy, you come here. Start this fire.
No, Mom, Mr. Matthews did.
That's all, Mrs. Martin.
Who's Mr. Matthews?
The man at the crashed plane.
Crashed plane?
Yeah, he broke his leg, so Timmy sent Lassie for help.
He didn't believe Lassie'd bring him.
So he shot off a flare.
And instead of went up, it went zing.
And landed out there.
Honest, Mom, you gotta believe us. Mr. Matthews is hurt bad.
In fact, I do. I believe you, darling. Paul! Paul, there's been a plane crash.
Plane crash? Where?
Right up the road, Dad.
Yeah, there's a man hurt bad.
Cub Scout on her?
Cub Scout on her.
Well, let's get a move on.
If I'd listened to your son, there wouldn't have been any fire. But then I didn't have his faith in Lassie.
Right handsome splint you got there, mister. Better job than I did on this thumb of mine.
Well, there the doctors have set my leg and splintered it up.
Them?
After all, they're combined age of 17, going on 18.
Well, how do you like that?
Well, very much indeed.
Of course, it took longer than you could say Jack Robinson.
Yeah. Huh?
And Mr. Matthews told us exactly what to do.
I'd still be trapped in that plane if it weren't for them. And Lassie.
Well, I think we'd better get you back into Calverton. I'll ride back here with Mr. Matthews.
You've earned a ride too, young lady. I'm mighty proud of the way you boys handled things.
I just did like Uncle Petrie said. Are these the good old days, Uncle Petrie?
Better in the good old days, Timmy boy.
Yep, much better in the old ones.